I don't think I'm going to die anytime soon, but Facebook has different ideas because it's already started telling me what to do with my ashes. I'm 32! I know I look a bit pale, but my God, it's mainly makeup. Anyway, one of the suggestions it made was that I do this thing called an eco-pot where I turn my ashes posthumously into a beautiful tree. This is written from the perspective of some kids 50 years after I died who are scared shitless of my tree. Don't go down to that tree, lads. It grew from the ashes of a poet. The bark smells like hyperbole and resentment. It's covered in a half-blood, half-rum sap, and they say if you stand beneath it and blare out your favourite tune, the wind will whisper, "What is that crap you're listening to?" It's not haunted, nothing so passé, but they say its branches bend if you use its shade to throw around clichés. The leaves in the right light turn from monda greens to purple haze, but try and take a picture, and it's gone. They say when Black Friday comes, you can hear it moaning as you pass, that its groaning, bending branches cast a shadow over this place, that there are lyrics chipped into the bark, but you can only see them when you're off your base. Try and take a picture, and it's gone. But no matter how tired you grow of the ache of the midday sun, don't go and stand in that shadow. You'll come back shattered, wistful, battered, and blissfully bleak. Don't go down to that tree, lads. It's sprung from the ashes of a freak.